couple, who'd been engaged for some time, left Clonmany, about 20 miles from here, to go to a dance at midnight, but they never got there.
A madman looking for a fight.
We will try and stop the sectarian murders by process of elimination, of the reasons why. We will educate them as to why they should stop. We'll educate them as to why they should never have begun. But in the ultimate, we would use physical force to stop it.
How much physical force?
I'm sorry, I say we're on television, we're on sound. I say, I'm not prepared to go into details.
If there is anyone in the building opposite the Europa Hotel, they are to leave immediately.
Seem to be running shebeens and strip clubs. Do you know anything about this?
Well, there are shebeens, but no strip clubs. I've yet to see one of strip clubs.
Is it collecting protection money?
It doesn't collect protection money from anybody.
Where does it get its funds from?
Our members pay a shilling a week. We're on ballots, we're on concerts, we're on dues, stuff to get our funds all legal.
Do you know why she was taken away?
No. She's never done anything.
She's never done anything.
She was always in the house next to Dr. Bengal.
Mm-hmm. Helen, I believe you're looking after the family. How are you managing to cope?
Okay.
How are you getting money, for example?
Well, we're on my mummy's earnest pension.
Mm-hmm. The children, I suppose they miss their mummy. Do they say anything about her at all?
Some nights they say I want my mummy back. And then they go off to bed and start to pray for my mummy. Before I told them yesterday to keep our fingers crossed and pray hard before I come back.
Six were killed altogether in these little streets during something like 5 hours of gunfire. The army says all six were gunmen. and is putting the hits down to the success of a new lightweight night sight, which is cheap enough to give to every soldier to put on his rifle.
Stop the mortars, nine. Get the British off the street, the cause of all our mortars. Support protest meeting to death, 3:30, Dunkirk Parade Square against British Army mortars.
The loyalist community is not using violence and does not propose to use violence if the democratic processes are permitted to operate in Northern Ireland. Nothing done to rouse passions by the organizers of yesterday's protest stoppage. The provocation, in fact, in many instances, came from the army.
Firefighting is a hazardous occupation. These men accept that danger is a part of their daily lives. But what has added to their bitterness today is the knowledge that Brian Douglas was murdered. He is probably the first fireman in British history to be shot dead for simply trying to do his job.
Shall maintain the union if it can be done. And should that be impossible, we would aim at a negotiated independent Dominion of Ulster.
Are brought from the prison to the courthouse by way of a tunnel which runs under the road. And it was in a room at the end of that tunnel that Bryson and a fellow prisoner pounced on their guards. Bryson, wearing prison officer's uniform, climbed a high wall behind the courthouse, discarding his prison officer's jacket as he went and disappeared into surrounding streets, and is once again amongst the most wanted of Belfast's IRA men.
Load up, we rub a bullet. sorrow. You're acting funny, trying to spend my money. You're out there playing your high-class games of sorrow.
This platform are pledged to use the democratic means once and for all to show the world where Ulster stands.
It was clearly part of an elaborate plan. The soldiers in their civilian clothes met the two girls by arrangement at a Lisburn hotel not far from Northern Ireland Army headquarters. They drove the 12 miles to the flat, where there was every sign of a party having been organised. One of the girls then said she was going to fetch more friends. When she returned, there were two men with her, one with a Thompson submachine gun, the other with a pistol. The four soldiers were made to lie on a bed and machine gunned one by one.
City, strung out on lasers and slashed back blazers and ate all your razors while pulling the waders, talking about Monroe and walking on Snow White. New York's a go-go and everything tastes nice. Poor little greenie. Ooh. Get back on it. Gene Genie lives on his back.
Mr. Whitelaw has ordered the demolition of about 100 tiny houses. Only two of them, though, are occupied.
One of the men shot last night has been called a UDA company commander. Would this not indicate that, in fact, the UDA was involved?
This is news to me because over the weekend I didn't know that this man was a UDA company commander. There's been 22 changes over the weekend and he could have been moved up into that position.
Daniel is driving tonight on a plane. I can see the red tail lights.
As far as we know, they asked who else was in the house, and she said Michael was in bed, and then upstairs, shot Michael, came down, told her only the children were there, she would have got one in the head as well, and they would get Tommy, they'd be back for Tommy.
Thank you.
Wilson was my election agent in this election in North Belfast. So far as I'm concerned, I'm not particularly worried now whether or not I'm elected. This is just something that's hard to imagine.
I speak with very great strength. A man over here shouts Lundy. Well, Lundy didn't get 16,000 first preference votes in this constituency, and I did. The problems that we face are the restoration of peace and the restoration of order in every part of Northern Ireland.
Stuck inside these four walls, sent inside forever. Never seeing no one nice again like you, Mama.
Gerry Adams was by far the most senior IRA man in Belfast, considered influential enough to have been released from Long Kesh to take part in these secret talks with Mr. Whitelaw just 1 year ago, and right at the very top of the Belfast wanted list.
Well, I don't know why I came here tonight. I got the feeling there's something right. I'm so scared in case I fall off my chair, and I'm wondering how I'll get down the stairs. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you.
They're grown men. I thought they should have more responsibility. I thought they act like children.
It was a bit disappointing, the carry on that went on. Well, I thought it was like a drunken brawl, you know.
I don't want an assembly, I don't want Stormont. I'd just like to be governed as Cornwall or Cumberland. When you go over there and you don't see any troops, you hardly see any policemen even. I think we should just be part of England. That's what I want to be.
As the brothers left the dock after receiving the heaviest sentences imposed for armed robbery in Ireland since the war, Keith Littlejohn paused. "Thank you, England," he said, and he went on, "Ask Carrington, the Minister of Defence, what he thinks about that lot." The discovery of his body ends a search which started 2 days ago when he disappeared after leaving the UDA office in East Belfast. Nobody knew where he was going, and he told his bodyguard not to come with him. It's known that Mr. Heron always carried a licensed gun, so the question now is how he allowed himself to be picked up by his eventual murderers.
You.
We're putting out a statement, and we've all agreed not to comment on it at all.
Read the statement.
It's a very nice evening, after so many hours, isn't it?
An excellent statement.
Right. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good night, Dennis. Good night.
Said if you follow this operation up, that man's instruction to shoot you. I just was a good boy and did what I was told.
Because somebody had a gun on you.
If I'd wanted to die, I could have dived the machine to the ground and killed a whole lot of us if I'd wanted to. But I'm too young to die.
Thank you.
Unless there is an overall unionist party majority on the executive, there won't be an executive, and I hope that'll be agreed. You can't plant me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow. Back to the howling old island woods. Hunting a hornet by town.
For far too long in the past, we have had pygmies. We have people who were not concerned about their fellow men on this island. They were only concerned with their personal fortunes, both private and political.
Stood here and told the press, I'm going to punch Mr. Faulkner in the nose. Nothing can be done in the House until I get up and do it.
I've just come from the bed of a widow whose husband was killed last night by a bomb. And I think of the tears in that widow's eyes as I go into this House and I see the behavior of these people, led by the demon doctor that preaches God knows what round the country. It's time it's got to stop.
What's it like to be out?
Well, with all the others, you can see we're only at the
gate. Only at the gate. Give it a chance.
Have arrived at a stage where an enormous amount of political movement has taken place. People have come together who were for years political opponents, determined to try and get a new life and peace and calmness back into this province.
And there he was, this young boy, a stranger to my eyes, strumming my bass with his fingers. living my life.